Two-factor authentication, or 2FA for short, gets its name from the fact that two things are required to verify your identity. Something you know, like a password, and something you have, like the verification code from your mobile device or physical token. Firstly, you would start off with a login page that asks your user for a mobile phone number. Upon submission, the user would be asked to input a verification code that gets sent to that mobile phone number via SMS. Once the user is verified, they can access the application. This tutorial will cover how to implement a verification token system with the Vonage Verify API and Express.js. The application will have three pages: an initial page that asks for a mobile phone number, a page where users provide the code sent to them, and finally, a page which they'll see if their code was correct and the verification successful. This tutorial will take you through the process from scratch. If you'd like to see the finished code, check out the Git repository for this project. The link is in the description box. Before getting started, you'll need an understanding of JavaScript, Node.js installed on your machine, and a Vonage API account. If you don't have one already, you can sign up today by clicking on the link in the description box and start building with free credit. Once you have an account, you can find your API key and API secret at the top of the Vonage API dashboard. Begin by creating a new directory and open it in a terminal. Run npm init-y to create a package.json file. Then, install dependencies. Type in npm install express, body parser, nunjux, and nexmo. Create an index.js file and set up the dependencies. Nunjux allows data to be passed to templates using the variable syntax. It is set up to automatically parse files in the views directory and is linked with the Express application stored in app. Create a directory called views and an index.html file inside of it. Now add the following. Create a route in index.js to render this view. Run node index.js in your terminal and open localhost 3000 in your browser. The form on index.html will send a post request to the verify route when submitted. Create a new route to handle this in index.js. By default, workflow 1 of the verify API is being used, which sends an SMS, then calls to read out a code, and then another call. The final step will wait 5 minutes before the whole request expires. You can pass workflow ID as an option if you want to change this behavior. The result will contain a status property. 0 means the action has been successful, and anything else means that there has been an error, which is passed to the rendered index.html page. If successful, check.html is rendered. Create check.html in the views directory. As well as the code, the request ID is required to check if the code is correct. Using the same method as message, the value of the hidden field request ID is provided dynamically. Like before, this will submit a post request to the check endpoint, as this is provided in the action attribute. Create a new endpoint in index.js. If the return status is 0, the check has been successful and the verification is complete. Create a success.html file in the views folder to celebrate. Congratulations on implementing 2FA. Hopefully, you'll agree that it was an enjoyable experience. In production, there are some additional considerations you'll want to factor in. For example, more robust handling of errors and non-zero status codes, providing the ability to cancel ongoing verifications, allowing users to indicate their preference between SMS and call-based code delivery, and lastly, you may want to use the Vonage Number Insight API to ensure only valid phone numbers are passed to the Verify API. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. Until next time, thanks for watching!